You're probably familiar at this point with a fight that went viral, caught on video, happening at a mall in Bridgewater, New Jersey. Well, the governor, Phil Murphy, has now responded to this video and the conversation about what seems to be fairly baked in racism by the cops in that video. Phil Murphy says, although an investigation is still gathering the facts about this incident, I'm deeply disturbed by what appears to be racially disparate treatment in this video. We're committed to increasing trust between law enforcement and the people they serve. Good luck with that mission. I am sure you're being very serious about your desire to produce that. If you are not familiar with this developing story, here is the video that initially touched off this conversation. Okay, so in the update that we just gave you, Governor Phil Murphy said that there appears to be racially disparate treatment. Appears. So what you saw in that video was a black eighth grader, a white high schooler that got into a fight. Happens from time to time. The cops come, they tackle the black kid. White kid, totally fine. Second cop comes, also gets on the black kid, the white kid, just fine. It appears, Jordan, to be racially disparate treatment. Why do you think that people think it appears that way?
I mean, the only like plausible reason for them to say something like that is just that we only have like 60 seconds to go by, so we don't know what happened afterward or what prompted it. But like, I don't really care. When you see the cops rush in and just tackle or go after the young black man who was underneath the white kid on top of him punching him, like that's all you need to see. That was the response. They saw a kid underneath this white kid and they went for him instead. I mean, there's no other, because clearly the white guy's the aggressor. He's on top of him punching him. So like that's, they saw black skin and they thought that's the guy.
Yeah, I mean, look, I'm not a big MMA fighter or anything. I'm not saying that you can't control a fight from being on your back below a person. Clearly, some people have those skills. But it seemed like the cop runs up, split second decision. The white kid's about to throw a punch. The black kid's about to ward off the punch. I've got to stop the warding off of the punch. So tackle him. Like, and by the way, maybe don't tackle either. Maybe just like pull the kid off of him and get between them. Of course, there's gonna be a jumping on them, a tackling. They resort to violence very quickly. And I get it, it is a fight between kids or whatever, but we do get to judge people based on the quick decisions that we make. These sorts of quick decisions pop up with cops quite a bit. In this case, thankfully, he didn't draw his gun. Because sometimes when those quick decisions have to be made and they have a weapon capable of killing someone, we know exactly how that goes. In this case, it's just fighting, but again, they make all the wrong decision. And again, Jordan, you were being incredibly fair. We don't know exactly what happened after. We do know that now both of those kids have been banned for some time from the mall while an investigation continues. I don't think that the mall needs to freak out necessarily. Fights in malls happen. If you're a kid of this age, that's probably where you're gonna fight, if not school. But I just think that the lack of willingness by a lot of politicians to speak honestly about what we see, like you don't have to like condemn the kid or the cop for the rest of his life or anything, but you can say, no, I totally understand how terrible that looks and we're taking it very seriously. You don't have to use these weasel words.
Right, and you know, we had a moment in 2020 where there was a huge national conversation around police tactics and bias in policing. And, you know, despite this huge groundswell of support, I mean, I saw one poll right after George Floyd's murder some 90% of America wanted or supported some sort of reforms for the police. And what happened? I mean, nothing. Democrats kind of, you know, glommed onto it for publicity. They did their kneeling and kente cloths and, you know, talked about how George Floyd was a hero and Pelosi thanked him. But at the end of the day, nothing became of it. I mean, the George Floyd Justice and Policing Act died in Congress. There's been no push since. And now you've got Biden and other Democrats calling for increasing police funding because they think that doing that will help mitigate calls to defund the police. But America's mostly in the middle ground. They want some sort of reform. They generally don't. You know, there are racists out there, but I think people who may have, you know, implicit bias, but don't quite understand the complexities of it, still want to be better. And they do support, you know, things that would mitigate circumstances like this. If that's your, you know, in your state, do something about it. Don't mince words and don't act like, oh, this appears to be racially motivated. Do something about it. You're the governor. Democrats across the board just kind of sleep on this issue because they govern from fear. They're just so worried about backlash. Just do something if you believe in it. That's why you should run for office, but they don't.
Yeah. No, you're totally right about the governing from fear. And this is one of, I think, the main areas where anything having to do with race, they are terrified of the attacks that will come from the right if they seem to be making any reforms whatsoever to weed out structural or individual racism. And I get that you should be a little bit worried about the attacks because they will come. The right is incredibly constantly racist. But we're just supposed to ignore it. We're just supposed to continue on same problems constantly. That is the position of the Democratic Party. That massive moment was wasted after so much work.
Well, they got a good photo op. That was pretty cool.
Well, they got a photo op. I'm not sure if it was a good photo op in hindsight.
It was pretty bad.
Yeah. Oh my God. Anyway, maybe Pelosi would prefer that one to the one in front of her fridge. I'm not sure. Maybe we can put up a poll. If she had to choose one to be her NFT Twitter profile picture, which would she choose?
For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.